Hi, it's Ian Boyd, the writer-director of the upcoming feature-length documentary film, Being Left-Handed. In doing a project like we're doing with Being Left-Handed, it's sometimes difficult. It's very time-consuming and sometimes disheartening when things don't happen as quickly as you'd like them to. But every once in a while, something will come up that will remind you of why you're doing the project in the first place, why it's so important, and what we as lefties worldwide are up against. One of those reminders came up today. As I was doing research, I came across an article from someone who is trying to debunk some of the myths about being left-handed. I'm not going to mention any names because I don't want to subject anyone to the junk that he writes. But he calls himself a skeptic, which I generally find to be code for someone with an agenda who is hiding behind fake science, fake facts, and flawed logic to attempt to discredit someone or something by giving the illusion of clear-minded thinking. They often quote sources and or studies that seem to be reputable, if you believe in our flawed system, that have been clearly debunked by real clear thinking and logic. They just don't tell you that. I started to read this article with an open mind until it became clear that the observations of this person were nothing more than backhanded insults to try to undermine left-handers without saying so. Basically, the article purported that all the positive things attributed to being left-handed, such as intelligence, creativity, and spatial abilities, were all mere myths. But all the negative traits, such as dying sooner, having mental problems, neurological issues, alcoholism, and allergies, were true, and that people should be compassionate to us because we're all going to drop dead soon. Of course, this was all done with an air of fairness and integrity. He also said that left-handers were underrepresented in science. I guess the names Tesla, Newton, Galileo, Einstein, Benjamin Franklin, and Darwin don't mean anything to him. As I've said more than once, left-handers don't die sooner. The early death myth originates with a 1988 Nature paper by Diane Halpern and Stanley Coren, Do Right-Handers Live Longer? The psychologists analyzed death records for baseball players and found that those who were left-handed had died younger. But most people in history didn't identify as lefties because they were switched around and lefties were demonized to such extent that their marriage rates were lower, producing less lefties until later in the century. Either way, it's a flawed study. Looking at my own life and having lived long enough to have people who have died prematurely around me, there's no discrepancy between the population percentages of the left-handers and their premature deaths in my life or my family. I can think of about 11 people that I know that have died early, and 10 of them are right-handed, and one of them is left-handed. And the left-hander died of a heart attack while trying to catch a bus. The same thing applies when talking about mental illness, neurological problems, alcoholism, where all the people in my life who exhibit these problems are right-handed. It's the same thing they tried to teach me in school. They told me that left-handers were remedial in math and English, and yet I was 4 years ahead in English and 5 years ahead in math. The math genius that I know is left-handed. Generally, I always try to concentrate on the positive aspects of being left-handed, because in my opinion, there are many. Having started to interview lefties, I'm always impressed at their intelligence and individual character. But there is still a very sinister attempt to try to undermine left-handers. Even in the Western world, where we are generally accepted, the propaganda has just become more subtle, but it's still obviously there. If you look up left-handed issues and facts in search engines, this kind of bunk is what comes up first most of the time, because it comes from more powerful and, in quotes, accepted organizations. This particular author would have done well to have lived in India or China at this moment in history where he could openly promulgate his fear and prejudice of left-handedness. But I will tell you, the days of left-handed prejudice and left-dominant demonization in general, in terms of physiology, are numbered. Left-handers are very difficult to control, very difficult to con, and they are very difficult to lie to. So those controlling the media and the governments do not like left-handers to have to contend with because they are a formidable adversary. One can merely look at the way China just switches all of the lefties into righties and then says it doesn't have any left-handers. Think about it. That is today in the 21st century and it's still happening. If you want a free society, you want people with strong right brain activity so they can see from a mile away the con jobs coming down the pike. I believe that in their own way, left-handers are the canaries in the coal mine of a truly free society, and anyone who ultimately has an open mind and ability to connect the dots. This dissemination of lies infuriates me, not so much for myself, and not even as much for the left-handers who live in a relatively free world and don't pay attention to it, but for my left-handed brothers and sisters who are still living oppressed and made fun of and ridiculed in places like India and China and Japan. That is just flat out wrong. The one thing that this article said that made sense to me was that left-handers are rare in societies where you're forced to be right-handed. Go figure. Obviously, that just means they don't admit to having left-handers, or as a left-hander, you're not allowed to use your dominant hand, like in parts of Asia. But that is an oppression of your very spirit and the way your inner self wishes to communicate and function within your society. To deny a naturally dominant side of your body or part of your brain that you wish to express yourself with is an insult to the Creator. It is an insult to your parents and their parents and the society at large. It's like telling someone who's tall that they need to slump. It's truly reprehensible that there are people living today that are not allowed to express who they are because of the fear and insecurity of those around them and the powers that control them. In the words of someone I interviewed recently, being left-handed is a gift. It is truly a gift, in my opinion, but not when you live in a society where they openly treat you as if you were a leper. It is my intention to be one of the people who helps to eradicate this archaic prejudice from the earth forever. And is it not our responsibility, those of us who've been freed from oppression, to help those who are still under it so they can be free as well? In the end, that is the mission of Being Left-Handed the movie, to do our very small part in making the world a more free and tolerant place to live in. I know that doesn't have the same weight as some larger issues in the world, but it is nonetheless important. Prejudice is prejudice, and it needs to go. And on that day, we will see globally the shift that has already begun to take place in the West, where instead of calling you a freak for being left-handed, they'll say, I wish I was left-handed. What a change. Please subscribe, like, and share, and thanks again for listening.